This guy's dangerous. This guy barely even makes it through any of his calls. He's dangerous, but he has game. He's old school. He's dangerous. He has game. Let's see what the plan is today. I'm going to Wichita. Mike in Wichita. Back in another smack-off. Let's see what he has today. Good to have you, Mike. How you feeling?
Man, I'm feeling pretty good. Working hard today, Jimmy. How about you?
I feel great. Having a great day.
Hey, I know exactly what you were thinking on the guy from Houston. I thought it was a taped call, too. The only thing that gave me pause was the crackback on the Golden Showers by whatever that guy's name is. You know, the smack off in the jungle has come a long way from hour number four to peanut giveaways to Planet of the Apes on VHS for huge facts of the day. But one thing that never changes, and that's clones being clones. Year in and year out, some guy finds the show, listens for a couple of months, and thinks, hey, that sounds easy, only to find him on the other end of the line with Jay Stu with his Save That for the Local show blast. But after 25 days in a row, Stu finally has had enough, and he's finished trying to save you from yourself. So he just says, screw it, and puts your name on the blink with a little number on the side that tells Jimmy, no, go to this guy next. That's when you hear the scratch of the phone going to you, and that exact moment Romy sends it to you, you realize that you're on the air on a radio station in 350 markets, and roughly 6 trillion people are anxiously listening to what Goober in Arkansas has to say. I'm tired of hearing that, quote, I'm not the typical clone. Yes, you are. You may not live in your mom's basement anymore, but you do share a bathroom with your grandma, and there's nothing cool or fresh about a grandparent's bathroom, and I've never had to convince a chick that I brought home in the middle of the night that, no, my grandma actually lives with me. Look, I'm not trying to say that I'm better than you. I'm just saying that I live better than you. And as for Jay Stu making fun of people for being, quote, readers, I'll just tell you like I used to tell the strippers I used to work with when I was a DJ in my 20s. First, I read because I know how to. And second, I like to read because I don't want to be your age and working at a strip club. Look, I know you're one step away from doing porn or taking up the offer from that geriatric septuagenarian that's been offering you $500 to take him on a trip, quote, around the moon. I know you hate your dad and you're an old 29. You have a snort problem that Charlie Sheen would be proud of, and you've got more ass than you've got class. But your baby daddy's out the bar spending your stripper money, all right? Really, Dave in St. Louis? You're a poor man's Jeff in Phoenix. Not one crackback on me. I stomped you like a narc in a biker bar, and you sissied your way through your phone call. Hey, Izzy, you made the smack off, the greatest event in the world, and you decided to try out new technology? That cost you a title, dude. Well, I am that weak smack. I gotta go. War, my niece and TJ and Lacey having a baby here in a few months. War, Mark Grace back in the jungle. That's all I got, Jimmy. Thanks for letting me participate.
You did it. Mike in Wichita, I told you, he's dangerous. He's dangerous. He's often on the line, then over the line, and does not make it through every phone call. Had a couple of moments there, but he did it. Strong effort. Mike in Wichita. All right, Mike, where do you slot him now? He warned Mark Grace back in the jungle. Mark Grace back in the day was the best interview the show had for a long time. Reigning champ for a long, long time. Mark Grace said things on the radio that no other pro athlete would ever say. And that wasn't a scrub either. That was a star ball player saying star quality things on the show and then just stopped coming on for whatever reason. Hey, man, that happens. That's why Elk's great. Elk will never not be here. Elk will always be a great friend of the program and a great interview. I mean, that's not saying that Mark Grace isn't a good guy. He just stopped coming on the show. All right, so Mike in Wichita made it through. 1-800-636-8686. It's strong, it's solid, but I'm telling you, some of the biggest lumber is still to come. Some of the heaviest hitters are still to come. When we come back, a part of that SoCal Mafia, I'll give you a hint. Come on, Joseph, run some smack.
Come on, Rachel, shave your back.
That guy. You know he's got to look at it. Folks will be taken down. Come on, Joseph. Run some smack. You are next.